Hello, Bethel Park gamers. I hope you enjoy gaming this weekend. My name's Anthony Beltran, and welcome to a new episode of Bethel Park Gaming with Colin.
Welcome, everyone, to Monster Hunter, to the world of Monster Hunter. More specifically, Monster Hunter Rise. Today, I'm mostly going to show you guys around some of the maps on expeditions, show you controls, weapons, and introduce you to my two partners in hunting, my furry friends, so to be, and my number one hunter, Pike. And this is Balto and Tom. Tom being the one sitting on a table, and Balto being the one who looks like a certain sun god from a Capcom game.
Sweet, man. Let's get to it, folks.
I'm back in this game now, boys.
Who is this guy?
Hey! What do you know?
Looks like a costume party. I'll be back! Give me out of this chicken outfit! What does that mean? Ah!
Oh, you got my
Yes!
Okay, so yeah, Balto is called a Palamute, and Tom is known as a Palico. They are my hunting buddies in this game. As for right now, I am currently equipped with fireproof armor and a layered armor for my feet, but it's also fire armor currently. Large monsters. Great Izuchi, Baggy, Kuluyaku. This is what he is. This is an actual picture of him. He's from World. Do not let Bird have stone. That's the one rule about him. Do not let Bird have stone. This is the guy who I have the arm gauntlets are from. Great Roggy, Poison Spitter, Azuros, Big Happy Bear. Well, not happy, but yeah.
Right, gotcha.
Legombi, Giant Snow Rabbit. This is Volvidon. Ankudson, he's basically a giant crane that looks like a cat. Most of the newer monsters introduced in this game look like were based off of Yokai. He's based off of that umbrella looking one with the one eyeball and one leg.
Yeah.
Yeah, because he can actually like, he actually like has this like frill thing on his head that'll like open up like it shows in the picture. I really need to, oh, I actually have a picture of him. See, this is what he looks like.
Beautiful.
That's him searching for food. I got a big old nice one for a load drop though. Big old sponge neck. those are actually sponges on his neck actually, because he shoots out water and stuff. Baroth, fun fact, this big guy, he eats insects. And here's the cool thing though, he has a charge attack and you wanna know how you'll know when he's doing it? He'll start whistling like a steam engine and come charging at you.
Wow.
And this guy who does these videos called Monster Mashup for World, and for the intro of the one for Baroth, the guy chipped over, wakes up Baroth in his mud pit, he's like, what are you doing in my swamp? And he does a head slam attack on him. It's funny. Kezu, no eyes, no ears, just a mouth and a stretching neck. Fun fact, he has no fight music. It's completely silent the whole time. That's how creepy he is. This is another guy. He is based off of Cap Kappa. This is Tetranodon. Sumo Duck Turtle. It'll eat up rocks and dirt to extend its chest while you're fighting it, so that way it can slam and ram you harder.
Oh
yeah, that's what I meant by sumo.
That is good.
Basiros, this guy, my weapon kept bouncing off of him because he's made out of rocks. Don't even get me started on his laser beam. Yes.
I'm a fire in my laser!
Tomigadachi, look at how, I am surprised at how camouflaged he is in that shot. Good lord, look at him. He was also introduced in World. He has membrane on his arms that let him fly like a winged squirrel, but he's also electric. So he's basically a giant squirrel lizard. This is Magnamolo. Oh my god, was this guy's fight crazy. He was the one that allowed me to step up in the high rank. Oh my god, when I saw it in an area where you're hunting him, he'll like go to the far corner of it, jump up into the air, and do a death charge attack at you. Oh, back when I first played World, this guy was a pain in the ass. It's like, okay, so you just finished fighting Tomigadachi, and you're thinking, yeah, you're thinking about yourself, you're going about yourself, you're liking this game.
Did you really believe it would be that easy?
Yeah, because this was the first guy who actually caused me to faint in World, and when that's what happens when you run out of HP in a hunt. You have like three tries. Once the third one happens, you fail the quest, and you're taken back to the main hub area. Nagakuga. Their tails have quills on them, sharp quills, and on the tip of their wings are blades. Basically, panther wyvern.
Nice.
I just hunted him yesterday, like, Mitsune, you what? I think that's him looking, that's Tom in the box. That's either my Palamute, that's either, let me get a close look. I believe that is either me or Tom. No, I think that's Tom in the corner there, about to get wrecked, absolutely. And that's him getting attacked by Sonocanth in the picture. Basically, happy Bubble Dragon. Here's the thing, though. Especially evolves Wyvern. Mitsune can secrete a peculiar foam that covers its foes and immobilizing bubbles. Basically just causes them to slip and slide around running. That's actually a status you can be given in this game. When I first saw it in Generations Ultimate, I was laughing my ass off. Because I was just like running around like this, like, ah! Anyway. Small monsters, these are like ones you'll find. Wild Balicos or Feline. Melanix, these guys will try to rob you. Kelbi, basically green deer. Tanukis. Bogabies, explosive Tanukis. Gargras, flightless big birds. Popo. How do I not have a picture of a Popo? Oh, here's a picture of a Popo and a baby.
Oh, cute.
This is Anteka. Slagtoth. Look at how happy he is. Kestadon. Pretty much those hard-headed dinosaurs, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
Renflops, miniature Triceratops. Bulfango, I really wish his big drome counterpart, Bulldrome, was in this game, but sadly, no, he's not. I enjoyed hunting Bulldrome. Jagras, introduced in World 2, these guys are like ones you'll find around the map that you can hunt for like very little stuff. Like the big monsters that you have to fight. Yeah. Usually if you have to go on a mission to hunt these guys, you have to hunt like a large number of them. They're not hard to fight. They're like fodder, basically. See how big the numbers are that I slain? I've only slain 3 of both fangos. Are you kidding me? I've slain 5, 10.
One.
Delex, these are sand fish. That's Tom and Baldo getting ready to wreck his ass. It's like time to die, boy. Okay, I'm actually going to go and remove Balto's Leo armor so you can see what he and Tom look like normally, and then we'll get started on a hunt. I'm sorry, I'm getting it. I just love showing stuff off for this game sometimes.
Yes, you do.
Okay, so this is Hinoa. She'll be giving my quest for story mode. There's a multiplayer hub area over there that we can still go into even if we're offline. It'll just be single player hunts, basically. This is a shop where you can get weapons, though I prefer making them at the blacksmith and the buddy smith. I actually imagined, like, during the intro cutscene of World, when you get separated from your palico, because you get hooked onto the main elder dragon you've been chasing at the beginning of the game. The reason they're chasing him is they're just studying him. So. The funny thing was, Tom, your palico gets hit by a barrel and you get separated, only to meet back up at the main hub area. But I imagine Tom being out of that, whenever he gets hit in the face of a barrel and falls off.
Oh, man.
Yeah, poor Tom. Of course, oh. I have this on my palico Ibuki currently, but yeah, I prefer having Tom just the way he is.
Dude, that dude just literally just walk on top of your screen.
Yep, they do that.
Why would they do that when they're...
They have to, yeah. It's how they're programmed, sadly.
Oh!
Yeah, this is what the Mysterious armor looks like on him.
Dude, he looks like a Transformer, man.
Yeah, I actually do imagine him balling up. But he has another thing I can do with him. I can ride him. Okay, this is a Iori. For buddy scouting is what gets you more buddies to do. These guys are currently some of the ones from my thing training to get their levels up. Tom and Balto have been leveling up as I've been hunting. Because I have them equipped. Oh, hey, you're back!
Who's back?
This guy, I sent him out on a little collecting thing yesterday. Miasune is probably haven't come back yet, but this guy sends them off. They leap off on like those ninja kite things, and then he gets out a giant fan and blows them away even farther.
Right.
Oh, it's not as brutal as how the deployment of Miasune was in World. They dropped them on an anchor, like on a like anchor platform thing. But the thing is, they like accelerate the dropping of it. It looks like one of them like lets go and flies off when it's going down.
Oh.
Yeah, it's just like. Are they okay? But yeah, they all come back fine. Hello, Inoa. Village quest. Not doing 5-star. Sonicant. Ooh. Barioth. I haven't really hunted one of him yet. Green's Possession. That's what Rathian's usually called. A queen. Volvidon. Beceros. Bashantan. No, it's good. Go on it. Go back, it's time to kill a monkey!
Let's go, accept this quest.
Good luck.
A dango!
No, not him.
What I wanted to do. There we
okay,
go.
Okay, there we go, just Canteen. Gets off it. Just eats.
Eat a meal. Hello? Let's see. I'll pay with my points. Let's go with my first run. There's usually a cutscene of her singing a song while they prepare it, but I'm going to skip that. Here's a victory for activation of effects.
All right.
And now let's go.
Let's depart to go to the quest.
Mm-hmm.
Which you already did, but that's fine.
Yeah, I'm redoing it because I'd want to do an easy one. Yeah, heck no, I'm not starting this video off of me going after Magnum Mall. Heck no. I'm going to wait a while until I get better weapons and stuff to go back after him. I got a sword and shield I want to make for him, make from his stuff, honestly.
Like you do say.
Oh, yeah, by the way, you did just see me send off a penguin. Okay, now, where is he on the map? There he is. He's off by Area 6. Okay, endemic life will sometimes boost you with stuff, help you, like, fight off monsters. Like, you can get, like right here, you can get a third wire bug. You can also gather stuff on the map, like bones used for making armor, or stuff for crafting, like, healing potions, like herbs. But I'm already full, so I don't really need those. Okay, here's big boy.
Wait,
where's my camera?
Why couldn't you just snap it on your Switch?
No, it has to be actual in-game camera.
Oh, okay, that explains why. Oh, got his rear end, though.
Oh, I got away from the turnaround, perhaps.
Come here, buddy. Come here. Oh, no.
Nice.
Yes, that was good.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, my God.
He's a big old boy, isn't he?
He is big. Look at him go.
That's my wire bug tech. That's my Switch skill. Oh, God, he just tried to chase. Oh, no, he's just on the wall. Get off.
Oh, he's down for a little bit. That's good.
Well, that's because this is a very high damaging doing weapon. Higher damage than I had when I originally hunted him. Meaning I'm probably going to be done with him faster than I originally was. He likes to toss fruit that he has on him. Likes to toss poisonous fruit. Bit of a pain sometimes. Kick his ass.
Let's go, man.
Okay, now when hunting monsters, you can break parts of them. Like you can cut off their tails, break wings. It'll cause them to... Ah! Hey, stop breakdancing on me. Right to the face. Give me that tail.
If only we know the stamina for this guy.
Oh!
Nope, never mind.
Ah, no, he threw a flashbang. No! No!
Not me. Ah!
Oh, they were stuns too, so they couldn't help me. Your partners will usually knock you out of stuns half the time. Oh, he dropped a bunch of stuff.
Oh, good. That's exactly what he needed.
Material, flash fruit. Oh, I can only have these till, like, the end of the hunt. Except for Bishamping Fur. I'd get to keep that. Okay, so now that other thing I was trying to say that you can do with firebugs is called wyvern riding, where you'll basically... Where you'll basically string them up with a bunch of wire bugs, and you'll be able to control them like a puppy. So you can like battle other monsters with monsters that it's very helpful sometimes in damaging them. Getting them in the turf wars, which are like cinematic like fights between the monsters, they're very useful for weakening the monster you're trying to hunt. I might actually catch this guy and show you how catching works. Because hunting, you basically just hit them till they die.
Uh-oh.
I dodged that, thank God.
Nice. It was like a split-second decision.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Weird move, but at least you didn't get damage. Almost? No.
Nah. Well, you'll know when he's getting tired for me to catch him because there'll be like a little blue symbol underneath his picture up there in the corner. My face.
I got you.
Ah, missed. Like I said, I'm not really the best hunter here, so... I think he might be getting enraged. I don't know. Some monsters are more, it's more easy to know when they're enraged, some not really. Ah.
At least you're almost there. Oh.
Got my ass. Oh, hey, but we hurt his hand, though. I need to sharpen. It's best that you keep this thing sharpened because you'll keep doing more damage if you do. Ah. Oh, God.
That is exactly what you did.
Yeah. Oh.
Where is he going? Come back here.
Yep, our hunter actually talks for once, unlike the previous titles where it really won, except whenever you'd get hit or something. Like you hear, ah, or something like that. But now you have, but yeah, his, oh no, you don't, pretty much signifies that the monster's fleeing to another area. And then he'll, like, shout out that it's going to hit hard when it's doing, like, a big attack, basically. Okay.
Here we go.
Ah!
Nope, not that.
I'm still getting the hang of the wire bug, though. Come here, buddy. Ow!
Ah! Come on, man, die.
These guys have a lot of health. I mean, ow! Stunned me. Thanks, Tom.
But still good on health, though, I can definitely tell.
Well, yeah, because of how tough the armor is I have. Knock him off.
Oh, there we go.
Mine? This is mine now.
This is all yours, man. As long as you have enough.
money.
Is it money or is that fruit?
As long as you have enough fruit.
Ah! I'm sorry, sir. I cannot give credit. Come back when you have a little. I don't know.
Yeah, I forget what the money's called this game. I think it's called Zelly or something. Where is he? There he is.
Come back when you have enough.
God darn it.
Zellions.
I just kept spamming this move with Anjanath yesterday when I was hunting him. It helped out a lot. Oh, come on. Get back.
Really? I know he got away. We gotta go get him.
Let's go. After his ass. We're not done yet.
There we go. Yeah. Nice. Got off of him and just started to attack.
That's what happens when you press B while riding your Palamute.
Oh, there we go. Get him. Now it's the time to
do something. Tired. He's tired. See how he's doing that? That means he's getting tired. Or not tired for me to catch him yet. No, it just means he's getting exhausted during the fight. They'll usually like run up to an area and find like the food they eat mostly.
But it's not here, right?
Right.
It's not here.
Oh, I just broke another part. I think I broke one of his hands or his face.
I clearly can't tell.
We toppled him. Help us, Jagras.
I was about to say, what is he doing here? It looks like he's your helper.
They'll either attack the monster or you. They don't really have a certain side. You can actually tame them in world and ride them, but that's part of something from Iceborne. I mean, you have to have Iceborne in order to do it.
Okay.
Ow! Whoa. Our parade is right for the capture. Thanks, Tom. Place this down. Ow!
Wow. Oh!
I have to wait for him to get in it, though, before I can catch him. Come on, buddy. Come get me.
Come here, boy.
Yeah, he went by it. Come on, come on.
Come here, boy.
Ah.
Really?
Over
at the wall?
Come on, come on, come on.
Over here, boy.
Over here.
Hey, there we go.
And now to drop him.
There we go.
And good night, sweet prince.
He is done.
Good night, sweet prince.
And you take some more pictures as good luck. Yeah. Returning to the village. Well, we'll do that.
Good job, buddy.
See? This is how friendly these guys are. I just love how much of a stupid nut I look like with that helmet. Seriously. Yeah. It looks like I can barely see out of that thing. I will take all, thank you. Balto learned elemental attack. What did Tom get? He learned Fleetfoot Feet support moves, and he learned Deflagration Relief buddy skill. Huh.
Awesome.
Mm-hmm. This is a fun game. I actually just honestly got back into playing it the other day, and I'm trying to get through it. Yeah. Maybe next time if I do this again, I'll show you guys off a Rampage quest. That one's more like a tower defense, base defense thing. It was introduced in this game. It's not too bad. Though there have been games where you had to like defend them against like giant monsters before. Let's give one of my lesser used ones. Let's give something.
What about that level 2 cat?
What level 2 one? Well, I'll get him up training, but I mean, you saw what they're training against. They're just training against a giant thing. And you want to know the other thing about that? That thing they're fighting is piloted by another Palico, so not really too much problem there. Okay, let's see. So I need for the park. I love that. Yeah, go to sleep. Oh my! Wait, hold up. Let's see a preview of this. He's a Bobby. One day, old chap. I'm here to club your head in. This is Slag Talk. I remember he's a frog.
Yes.
Rhinopelops. Oh yeah, these guys. They become like heavy armored bears.
That's very interesting.
Jaggy.
Oh, the knight.
Soldier, more like, is what it's technically called. Kulu.
What? What is that?
I am now Arabian. Roggy.
And Mexican.
Hola, senor. Okay, you know what? We're making him this. Hola, senor. Oh, yeah, feline acorn. I actually had the acorn armor, the hunter-sized acorn armor on Pike in Generations Ultimate, because that... I have that on, feet,
mm-hmm.
And, I don't really play much of Ultimate too much, because, well, continuing on, the story is getting difficult to do, it's a higher difficulty, but I'm making it through otherwise.
There he is.
Hola, senor! Okay, let's see what a better Okay, and consume. Let's see what this looks like.
Oh, yeah, man.
Full out knight. Ludroff.
All right.
Baroth.
Nut. Maid.
Kezu. No. Nurse.
Oh, even better.
If the nurse is coming to give me a shot of that big ass thing, I'd say hell no. And be running in the opposite direction. Tetranodon. Look, fun fact, he doesn't shoot anything with that. He uses it as a club. If you see them have any sort of like gun-like weapon on their back, they're not using it as a gun. It's only going to be clubbing something in the head. Look at that.
What is that, a big like
shuriken? Yes. And then here's that thing I got from the shrine. Uga Chaka. I already have that. Okay. And let me introduce you to one last little buddy, a friend of mine. This is my Kahoot. Hootenanny.
The penguin.
No, read what his name is. Holler in a Hootenanny. Yes, this is Laird costume form. I have a bunch. I can make him like a little. This is what a Kahoot normally looks like.
So cute.
But yes, for right now, puffy little penguin. I can also make him a little dragon. But I prefer the penguin.
Defer to penguin?
Yep, prefer to Bagman.
All right.
Time for food.
All right, so thank you all for watching this episode of Bethel Park Gaming, and make sure you like and friend me at Bethel Park Gaming's Facebook page. Do not forget to subscribe to BPTV's and Bethel Park Gaming's YouTube pages. Keep on gaming.